In this video, you'll see how to set up an Amazon Aurora MySQL zero-ETL integration with Amazon Redshift that includes data filtering. With this integration, you get an easy and reliable solution for running near real-time analytics and machine learning on petabytes of transactional data with no complex ETL infrastructure to maintain. You can also define the replication scope using data filtering. This saves costs when performing analytics on fewer tables and makes it possible to exclude tables with sensitive personal information. A zero-ETL integration simplifies setting up and maintaining an analytics data pipeline between a source, in this case Amazon Aurora MySQL, and a target system, in this case Amazon Redshift. You can use both operational and analytics databases for your respective workloads. Once your operational data is in Amazon Redshift, you can leverage a number of powerful analytics tools and features. To create an integration, we need a source and a target. For demonstration purposes, these resources have already been configured. To get started, let's navigate to the Amazon Relational Database Service console and look at our source. Our source is an Aurora MySQL database cluster named zero-ETL demo. Next, let's navigate to the zero-ETL integrations page. This page guides you through the steps required to create a zero-ETL integration, which include preparing the source database, preparing the target Redshift data warehouse, and creating the integration itself. Now, let's create an integration. First, we'll give the integration a name. Next, we'll select the source. We can browse to available RDS databases. RDS automatically filters to supported engine versions. We'll keep zero-ETL demo as the source. RDS validates the parameter settings for the database cluster. In this case, the parameter values need to be fixed. We'll have RDS fix them for us. Now, we can also perform data filtering by including or excluding databases and database tables based on a comma-separated list of filter expressions. For this example, we'll include all tables from sales and marketing databases and exclude all tables from the HR database. RDS will create a new DB cluster parameter group based on the parameter group that is currently associated with the cluster. Then it will make changes to the Aurora Enhanced Binlog, Binlog Replication Global DB, Binlog Row Image, Binlog Backup, Binlog Format, and Binlog Row Metadata Parameters. To allow RDS to make the parameter changes and reboot our database, we'll enter Confirm. Let's reboot and continue. RDS is now fixing the parameter values. We can view more details from the information panel at the top of the page. RDS has created a parameter group, modified it to apply the correct parameters, and associated the source DB cluster with the parameter group. It is currently rebooting the source database. Next, we'll select the target Redshift data warehouse. We can choose a Redshift data warehouse in our current AWS account or in a different account. To specify a different account, we'd simply enter the Redshift Data Warehouse ARN. In this case, we'll choose an existing Redshift Data Warehouse in our current account. Our Redshift Data Warehouse does not have the correct resource policy to support zero-ETL integration. We'll have RDS fix this for us. RDS will update the target data warehouse resource policy with the authorized principal and authorized integration source and will enable case sensitivity for the target data warehouse. We'll select Continue to apply these changes. Optionally, we can add tags and customize the encryption settings. We'll skip this step. Let's review the settings and create the integration. It can take up to 30 minutes to create the integration. Let's fast forward to when it has been successfully created. The last step is to create a database in Redshift that is linked to the integration. To do this, we'll navigate to the Amazon Redshift serverless console. Next, we'll go to our namespace and open the details for the integration we created. We'll now create a database from the integration. The database has been created. Now, data written to our source database cluster will be replicated to our Redshift database. We can view integration metrics at the bottom of this page. These metrics will be populated as soon as data starts flowing. This information will also be available in Amazon CloudWatch. In addition, we can view statistics for tables that are currently active or have errors and leverage all of the other powerful tools Amazon Redshift has to offer. You've just seen how to set up an Amazon Aurora MySQL zero-ETL integration with Amazon Redshift that eliminates the need to manually build ETL pipelines, and how to perform data filtering to save replication costs and protect sensitive data. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.